Hello, my name is John Connolly. I'm a food development and training chef for Mellors, and today we're going to do some basic knife skills. The first thing I'm going to do is show you an array of knives and show you what they're used for. Then I'm going to show you how to clean them and how to sharpen them and tell you how to store them. So we're going to start off with this knife. This is a cook's or a chef's knife. This is used for chopping. This is the cutting edge, this is the point, and this is the heel. This is a carving knife, and this is used for joints of beef or any roast. We also have a bread knife, which is also used as a carving knife. A palette knife, which has no blade and no serration, and is used for icing or smoothing pastries. Then we have a boning knife, which is used for taking bones out of meat joints. This has got a solid edge. If it was a little bit longer and had a flexible blade, it would be a filleting knife for using for things like fish. Then we have a paring knife, and this is used for salad prep. And this is the steel, which we're going to use to sharpen the knives.
So John, why is it important that we have sharp knives then?
Okay, the reason why we have a sharp knife is so that we don't cut ourselves. It's for safety. The sharper the knife, the better, because it then works for the job that it's supposed to do, for cutting through what you wanted to cut through, as opposed to it slipping and cutting you instead. So this is how you would sharpen the knife. There are lots of different ways to do this, but my preferred method is to keep full of control, to keep steel onto the board, knife in the right hand or left hand, and then run the blade from heel to point down the steel on both sides. And you do this about 10 times on each side, and that should bring the blade back and make it sharp. So that's how you sharpen your knife. Now the next thing I want to show you about is how to clean your knife. It's really important not to leave the knife in soapy water. And the reason for this is quite obvious, but you'll be amazed how many people do it, and that is because once it's in there, if you walk away, somebody else doesn't know it's there, they can't see the blade is in the water, they could put their hand in, and they could have a nasty accident. So it's really important, once you start to clean your knife, you go through the whole process in one go. So what we start off with is, there's some nice hot soapy water. You should hold your knife with the blade pointing down. If we wipe away, make sure that we clean the blade thoroughly, and then wipe the handle and make sure the handle is clean thoroughly as well. And then using some blue roll, dry the handle so that it's safe and easy to hold, and then do the blade. And when we store the knife, the best place is on a metallic wrap, or on a knife box. Some people use a knife drawer, which is not the best practice, because the knives clash together and that can make them blunt. And finally, when we're moving the knives from place to place, always hold the knife down by your side and walk with it kept nice and close to you to avoid accidents. If we walk like this, or if we hold the knife like this, we could fall and we could stab ourselves or somebody else. The best way is down by your side. And that's it for knife skills.